They may have been hit hard by the effects of COVID-19, but musical legends like Steve Kekana and others remain committed to their craft and calling.
This COVID-19 presented itself as a very, very bad kind of a thing to all musicians, because you must remember, we couldn't make shows, we couldn't gather, we couldn't even invite other musicians to come and record. It was like the end of the musical field. But thanks God, he saved us. We're still here. I hope by next year we will be giving people music.
The Weekend Arts Festival is held annually to honor and recognize artists with disabilities. They also suffered major setbacks this year amid the COVID-19 pandemic.
We saw a need to bridge the gap, because it could not be right that during these days, when they are celebrated calendar months, disabled artists are not featured in any way. So we are so proud to present this initiative, and we thank the National Department of Arts and Culture for coming on board with us on this journey.
The event has also been organized to promote social cohesion.
Girl, I am worked in a long time, okay? Because we as musicians gather people together. So the thing of us not being able to do just exactly that was the issue. So now, obviously, that means we're not going to work if we're not going to be able to bring people together and tell them, oh guys, I've got this new song, let's jive or whatever, you know what I mean? So it was rough. Rent, bagiti, oh Lord, food. Now you have to go back home and all that stuff when you used to be independent and, you know, doing things for yourself. So it really did take isinkwa out of our mouths.
For now, the aim is to ensure that the rights of artists with disabilities are respected and that they are not marginalized as they practice their craft. More artists with disabilities will be honored at another Weekend Arts Festival on the 10th of December. Prudence Makubalo, SABC News, Johannesburg.